Now in this video, let us look at the linear search algorithm. I've already created a video for linear search and binary search on the whiteboard. If your preference is to watch the videos on the whiteboard, then you can just check out my channel and you can check the videos where I'm teaching this exactly same algorithm in the whiteboard. And here I'm trying to solve the same algorithms in a PPT format, or you can say I'm just going to write down things. I'm just going to show it step by step. But that totally depends on the preference of the student that how you want to watch it. Okay, so the linear search, what's the problem statement? Problem statement says, given an array of n elements, write a function to search a given element x in that particular array. Now, what does that mean? It means, let us suppose we have an array like this. This entirely is representing an array. Now in this array, there are elements which are 0, 1, 2, 3, up to so on, total n minus 1, or you can say in total, we have total n elements. Now out of this array, you want to search any particular element, which can be say the element j. So to search that element, if that element exists inside this array or not, we are going to write a program, and there are so many different searching algorithms that are present for this, and one of the simplest, or you can say the easiest algorithm that is present is the linear search. Now what exactly is the linear search? The linear search simply says that go to every index location and check if that particular element is present or not. Now these elements which are present in this array, they can be in sorted or they can be in unsorted format. So for example, let us say here in this array, in case of linear search, what we are going to do is we'll go to the index location 0 and we'll say whether the element j is present in the index location 0 or not. Now if that element is not present in the index location 0, then I'll go to the index location 1 and I'll see whether the element is present in this location or not. If the element is not even present in the index location 1, then look for the element in index location 2, then look for the element in index location 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, until we find this element. Now, if that particular element is present inside this array, then either we can return the location of that element, or we can return just positively as 1, that yes, that element is not present. If that element does not exist inside this array, then we can just return minus 1 to say that no, we cannot find that particular element. Now in 99% of the implementations, what we do is we try to give the index location where the element is present. Now let us look at this strategy in more detailed fashion, or you can say in a step-by-step algorithmic fashion. Here you can see we want to find that particular element j inside this array. Now what we can do is start from the leftmost element in the array. So this is the leftmost element inside this array, and one by one compare every element with this. For example, let us suppose we want to search for the element j. So we'll start from the leftmost element and we'll see whether this is equivalent to the element j. If not, then we'll go to the next index location. So we are referring this element j as x. Okay. So if x matches with an element, then return the index location of that element. Otherwise, if it does not match inside, after scanning this entire array, that means you searched at every single index location inside this array, and if we cannot find that particular element, then we are just going to return minus 1. As you can see, this is a very, very easy implementation, or very easy step to perform this linear search. Now, how can you write a program? So obviously, to write this program, we are going to need loops. Okay. So now let us see how we can write this program. For this, we are going to write a function, which is linear search as a function. Now in this function, we are going to take integer error, that means this particular array, as the input. And we are going to take the input as number of elements as integer n. Now we'll write a function which is going to use loops. So we can use the for loop here. For that, we are going to take integer I. So for I is equal to 0, that means we want to start from the index location 0. We want to go until we find the element or the last index location. So I is less than 24, or you can say less than n and I plus plus, because here, as you can see in this example, the index locations are 0 to 23, which is actually there are 24 index locations because the number is starting from 0. So the value of n is 24, but if I say I is less than n, that means the value of n is less than 24, which is actually maximum value is 23. So we'll see whether the last index location is having that element or not. Right, so we are going to go to the last location. Now we'll check for checking whether that element is present or not, we have to take that element as input with it. So we are going to take integer data or the element x that we want to search. So we are going to say if arr of I, that means for this index location, for any index location, if that element is equivalent to x, that means if this is containing that element equivalent to x, or if this is not, does not contain, then we'll go to the next index location, we'll see whether it is containing that element x or not. Then we are going to say that yes, we found the location, so we are going to return that location I. But after the end of this entire for loop, that means after finishing the entire loop, if we cannot find this element, then we can just return minus 1 by saying that searching was not successful, which is going to say integer as the return time. So it's very simple, guys. Again, I'm telling you that we are writing a function which is taking the array as input, the total number of elements inside the array, and the element that you want to search. Then we have created an integer I for this for loop. We'll see that for every index location from 1 till the last index location, which is n minus 1, so it is going to run this loop till the maximum value of I can be n minus 1. So from the 0th index location to the last index location, if the value at that location is equal to x, that means if we can find the element x, then we can return that particular index location at which location the element is present. For example, here j is present at the 9th index location, so we are going to return the value of as 9, and this function will terminate. But after the end of this for loop, if we never hit this return, that means we cannot find this element, therefore we are going to return minus 1 to demonstrate that the search was unsuccessful. This is called as a linear search. Now for this linear search, this is a function they've already written here. So this function, again, this is the same implementation, exactly the same implementation here, just we are saying, I mean, here in this implementation, I'm just writing it as a code in a clean manner. Okay, now what will be the time complexity of this linear search? As you know, it is a very, very simple, it's very easy to find the time complexity. So in case of best case is that you tried searching for that particular element and you found that element at the exact or beginning or the first index location, so that means it is going to take order of 1 as the time complexity. But if I say what is the worst case, will be when you tried searching this entire array, after going through this entire array, you still cannot find the element, or the element does not exist, or maybe the element is present at the last index location. That will be the worst case. In that worst case, you have to search the entire array from beginning till the end. Therefore, the worst case, the time complexity will be order of n, because you searched the entire array, or you can say this entire loop will run from beginning till the end. Okay, so entire loop will run. That is why in the worst case, the time complexity is order of n. But what is the average case? Now, average case says you can find the element at the first location, you can find the element at the second location, you can find the element at the third location, fourth location, and so on. So let us say the number of comparisons for the first location will be 1. If I say, we tried the searching for the next time, and the element is found at the second index location, so number of comparison will be 2. If I tried searching for the third time and the element is found at the third index location, therefore the number of comparisons will be 3. In the same way, the element found at the nth index location, that means we tried n times, and n times there's a probability that element can be found at any of this location. So we taken all the cases and we divide it by n, so that is going to give us the total average time where the element will be found. So on an average, it will be n into n plus 1 divided by n. So this is sum of n natural numbers. So it is going to give us order of n as the time complexity of theta of n. Therefore, in case of linear search, the average case time complexity is theta of n. But what about the space complexity? Now, in case of linear search, the space complexity is going to take order of one time, because we are not using any extra space in terms of stack. So we are only using this program, which is an iterative program, which is a non-recursive program, and we are not using any extra space. Therefore, the space complexity for linear search is order of one. I hope that we have already seen this linear search so many times. We have already discussed it so many times. It's very, very simple, guys. Linear search is one of the most simplest program or the simplest algorithm that is present out there in terms of the subject, which is ADA, or you can say design and analysis of algorithms. Now look at the next searching algorithm, which is the binary search.